I'm also muted. Okay. That's intriguing. Twitch is telling me that I'm offline, but it's also showing me my stream, which is super useful. So let me grab my desktop here, and we can take a look at our super dorky spreadsheet. Bam. Oh, I know why it's blank. One moment. We're going to switch to my Hangout screen while I screw around with this. It doesn't like it when I'm running Skyrim in the same window as my spreadsheets, so I need to rearrange that. So be prepared for Infinity Gym for a moment. Hey TJ, how's it going? I am attempting to get my life figured out. Ooh, look at that. It didn't even screw up. There we go. What? What are you doing? XSplit? No, stop it. You were so close. We're so close, XSplit. What have you done? Oh. Beginning of stream. Always the weirdest time. Yeah, there we go. Infinity. Double infinity. Let me just screw around with that. For some reason, it wants to store my window information, which isn't a great plan, because I only do this once a week. If I were a career streamer, that would probably be a lot more useful. There we go. Look at that. Look at me. Spreadsheet super pro. Anyway, so far, last week we unlocked two characters. We unlocked Raiden, because we got a lightning spell and it rained, and Henry. Because we joined the Imperial, we got the Join the Legion quest. We haven't joined the Legion yet. And we killed some Stormcloaks. So to remind everybody, the way this works is this is a multiplicity. All of these people, including the three bonus characters that you might see on a weekend stream coming up on Saturday or Sunday, depends on how my preparation for Maker Expo is going. But all 12 of these people are our Skyrim characters. We made them together back in week 2. And they have personalities, they have stories, and they're all going to live in the same world. So right now we're just rolling with Janet the Dragonborn. But they all have sort of different interests, you can see, from the quests that they're going to pursue. They're eventually probably going to wind up with places to live. They might fall in love. They might have specific people they hang out with. And then, of course, they each have their own sort of unique fighting style and little descriptions. I really like Nicholas, who's a wizard super fan, because we gave him like full-on tattoos, like faces of wizards all over his body. It's great. We'll get there. Don't worry. And then, yes, the four bonus characters who you'll see on weekend streams, because that's going to be a little slower, a little less action, a little more commerce. But even the commerce side has a story. I'm going to drink this cola that came with my dinner. So anyway, let's actually get into the game. Alright. Alright, come on Skyrim. I believe in you. Yay! My version of Skyrim as it says down below, is super ridiculously modded. I have about 240 mods that I still haven't managed to publish the list of, but I really need to do that. And I have the list now. I just need to actually put it up on the site. But this is Janet. Janet is our Dragonborn. She just killed her first dragon, which is why she can do that. Also, I turned down the game audio a bit because it was a bit high in previous streams. So if you have any thoughts about how the audio balance is between my voice, I point at my face when I talk about my voice because that way people know it's me. And the game audio, let me know, because I'm still fine-tuning that. And it's a tricky thing to measure when it comes out on the other end of the stream. So yeah, let me know. And we're hanging out with our bros, the Drunken Knight, Cosnic, the People's Archer, Feindahl, and Mercurio, the handsomest mage who ever lived. Look at this man. Look at this man. Oh. We got some new armor. I opted out of the skimpy barbarian armor because it wasn't really doing it for me. I mean, I get that, like, Janet is not ashamed of her body. I mean, she's got this sick-ass dragon. Actually, without the backpack, it looks pretty cool because it shows off her sick dragonborn back tattoo, so we're going to roll with it. Well, yeah, we've also got the scaled armor, or the Whiterun guard armor, for when it gets, you know, cold. We're not going to be running around in snowy climes with wearing barbarian bikini. Partly because it sort of breaks my immersion. Partly because I don't want to. And partly because we will literally freeze to death thanks to Frostfall. Oh, bad people. Hello, friend. Oh, fox friend. Oh, goodbye. What's up, Bandit? So today, we're going to explore the world a bit more. And we are going to do some bounties, I think. We're going to kill some bandits. We're going to kill maybe some wizards. So we're going to try and get some money so we can buy a horse. What's up? Give me your soft, unprotected wizard flesh. Oh! Yes! Don't fuck with Janet. That person also dead. That's a rat. Also dead. Wolf. 100% dead. Alright. And one of the things we bought last time, loot magnet. It's a spell that just loots the bodies of everyone around us. Yeah, TJ, you did miss the spreadsheets. We're going to come back to them probably just before the break. But I know that you're in a different time zone. Ooh, pickpocket skill. But I agree that the spreadsheets are the best part, and I am going to embed the spreadsheets on the website probably later tonight, assuming I don't get distracted getting ready for Maker Expo. Akari, you could take those prizes and eat them. We found our own source of skooma. By the way, Janet, not cool with skooma dealers. We already killed one. I guess technically these guys, so four. The real stuff. Make sure they know what that seer of yours is really up to. I want to hang out around here for a bit longer. We're getting a little close to wait. So we're going to talk to Feindahl. Feindahl's inventory is getting pretty full. And that's one of the things we're going to take care of on the weekend, is we're going to just sort of go through and sell all that stuff or process it into other objects or things like that. So it's going to be slower and boring and still fun, but a different kind of fun. Get these dragon bones. We don't need them. Oh yeah, we stole the golden claw. There we are. Now we're well within... Yeah, skooma is Skyrim drugs. It is There, let me get my headphones off my head. Now I can hear myself talk a bit better. Skooma is Skyrim drugs. It's more like... like, because it's a drink. So it's less like, you know, like heroin or something like that. But it's essentially analogous to... No, we're good. It's analogous to that kind of thing. And we're also going to cast our buff spell. Buffs are good for you. And it builds our skill, and it helps our stamina regeneration, so we can smash things more. Oh, God. Come on, open. Shit. Opening chests that are this difficulty early in the game is awful. I'm usually pretty good at this, but not while I'm on stream, apparently. No. Oh, and our Skyrim crashed. So that is a thing that happens. The problem with using lots of mods is your game crashes. Let's just take us a minute or two to start back up. Probably less than that, but I'm ballparking the time. There we go. The question is, when was our last save? Because usually I'm pretty quick on the quick save, but I think I got distracted starting the stream. So we might need to go and murder a group of people, or maybe we'll go do something else and we'll come back to those people. We also haven't adopted any kids yet. Forges and grindstones. Oh, we're going to make some cool armor. Maybe Saturday. Yeah, so we are right back at the beginning. Sweet. Okay, so real quick, hand feigned all a bunch of my crap. We opted to keep the barbarian armor because we're going to rock that sick back tattoo. And we're going to get rid of basically everything in here because we can't use the soul gems yet. We need to get a soul trap weapon. That is definitely on our things to do. Just need to make some adjustments here. Makes me nervous because every time Skyrim crashes or reloads, it drops a couple of frames. I'm like, but shit happens. So instead of going and killing those guys again, believe me, they'll get theirs. Oh, that was a good time yesterday. Did I leave the dragon skeleton in place? I don't remember. It might be hanging out back around the corner there. We are going to go to... kill the bandit leader at Redoran's Retreat. Which is probably the hardest Whiterun bounty. So that's fun. Yeah, I approve of Janet's back tattoo. You can also just see her leg tattoo. She's also got like a Fusro Da on her forearm. Because she's a badass. With a giant axe. Look at that. Like, just look at that. And this game looks bad. Like, this game came out years ago. Sup, Wolf? Oh, you're dead. Goodbye. Who's that? That's a bandit. There's no way that's not a bandit. Nobody else in this world wears bone mold armor but bandits. I knew it. Oh, headbutt. Yes. That was a crossbow bolt in my shoulder. It's too bad I was busy literally headbutting that guy apart. Everyone has great tattoos except for Nicholas. Nicholas's tattoos are awful. Just checking my Facebook. Hopefully the stream does not end prematurely tonight. I am on call at work, so if my work phone goes off, stream over. Wizard, come here. It's cool, I have something for you. Oh, there it is. Oh. Something about that makes me sad about Skyrim is that unlike... What? Oh, it's like a skeever or something. Unlike Fallout, you can't just, like,
bandits are desperate men.
Dismember people. Like, in Fallout, you can shoot someone in the face and their arms will fly off. And you can't do that in Skyrim, and I feel like it would really... I don't want to say it would be a lot of fun, but it would satisfy visceral desires that I have, that I tend to have when wielding a giant axe. Like, say now. Hello, new friend. Oh, that dog had an accident. Hello, other new friend. Oh! Oh! That was... Is there an arrow through your face? Sorry about that. I mean, obviously not... for real sorry, but... kinda sorry. So... this is the toughest part, because there's a bandit chief coming up. These guys have a lot of health, they have big two-handed swords. Yeah, I remember having one of those swords. And we basically have to fight him in a claw. So if we're not careful, he's going to wreck our shit. But... ooh! Yep. That sword. So big. Ooh. Man, we're not having a good night for this. I might need to do some tweaking for the mods. Should be fine, though. Just curious. But this time we've got a more recent save, so I'm not too worried about it. I've also got the autosave set to max for exactly that reason. Although I could just hang out on the title screen and listen to the music. Yeah, follow people flying apart is amazing. Like, you punch somebody in the arm and both their legs fall off and you're like, wow, I'm a god. Skyrim, I hit you in the face with an axe and your intact body falls to the ground. Yeah, so we're right up on that bandit chief fight. So we need to stay a little further back. Now this guy's dead. Super dead. But, like, he's gonna put down our people. Gotta get out of that swing. And I think we're actually... oh, there we go. Wizards. Gotta love them. That's why we bring them for backup. Yeah, we're thirsty. So let's see if we can't get some... water. Do we have water yet? We're still looking for some stuff to make water skins. So no, we don't have water. We have river water, but we're not gonna drink it. We're gonna drink some beer instead. Drinking river water makes you sick, kids. Or it can. And we don't really want to get sick. So, loot magnet to pull off all they've got, and we'll go through it in our inventory. So we've got some illusion spell. Getting a lot of armor here. Nothing really great, though. Cosmic, you don't get new armor. You get to enjoy your uniform. Oh, wait, we're putting this in the wrong guy. I'm not going to say where we found this armor, but spoilers, we killed a bunch of Thalmor for it. I regret nothing. Thalmor dicks. Janet is indeed glowing in the dark because she has a buff spell on her. We're not going to use the giant sword because we learned our giant sword lesson last time. Giant swords only suitable for certain areas. Yeah, Janet's got a buff that improves her stamina and her magic regeneration. It's also helping us build our alteration skill, which will let us do better illusions, better buffs later. So let's grab some stuff here. Welcome to Skyrim, scavenge through barrels. We're mostly just looking for rolls of paper. Rolls of paper. Disarm this bear trap and look in this chest. Ooh. Rolls of paper are going to let us... Also firewood. Because we're going to freeze to death. Remember that time we almost freeze to death? Yeah, I froze to death? Yeah, I do. Rolls of paper are going to let us make water skins, and water skins are the bomb. So, fingers crossed. Like, you get a couple rolls of paper, and you're in the money. And it doesn't look like we're going to get lucky. But we do... We're finding a bunch of, like, tangentially useful things. Oh, roll of paper. There we go. Water skins can carry lots and lots of water. So they're really super useful and compact. Also, this wood, because we don't want to freeze to death. Okay, this chest I can do. There we go, first try. Conjure Weeping Daedra, God. One of the wonderful things about having so many mods is half the ship don't even know what it does. There are mods that I've never interacted with. And sometimes I'm like, well, I've never interacted with this. Maybe I'll take it out. And other times I'm like, oh man, so good. Alright, we're not going to take the spoiled meat and the goat cheese wedges and all the rest of that. We're just going to head out. Do this. So I've now.
Now ain't this a surprise?
Oh. Hello. Goodbye. Ooh. Wrong place, wrong time there, son. I mean, to be fair, there wasn't really going to be a right place for it, or a right time, but. Alright. Well, let's head back and clean out those other guys. And then maybe we'll be a baller and head over to, like, the rift. Take that, fox. Take that. Super didn't have a good plan for tonight's stream. Because we're at sort of that crux where we can try and continue the main quest. But to do that, we have to climb the steps. And to climb the steps, we have to... Oh, man. It's... Let's try it, though. We've got an hour of Janet time. Let's kill these guys. Loot spell loots everything, including their clothes. And we're so yeah, let's kill these punks. And we're gonna turn in our bounty and get another one. We might also become Thane of Whiterun, but I think we'll save that. Then we'll walk to Iverstead, and if we have enough time after that, we'll go up the steps and we'll meet the Greybeards. We're gonna need firewood though, because otherwise we're gonna die. That is the big problem. Oh, we might also need a tent. Okay. So our earthbound weapon just leveled up. So we're going to Forgotten Magic. Druid. Oh, we got 2 points. Alright, so we got the... additional... damage, or additional health and stuff like that. So let's get some... damage related stuff. What's up, nerd? Ooh! I'm the mean bean machine. And we leveled. It's an archer. Hello. You're dead. Those people look friendly. Hello, person. You seem friendly. You're not. Headbutt you. Excuse me. Hit you so hard, my Skyrim alt-tab. Oh, bounty bandit. Nice. How about her, too? Yeah, now we're talking. Advantages of loot magnet. I don't have to go and find people's bodies. Sometimes, you have a busy day, you kill a lot of people. You don't always have time to go and look for them. Alright. Fangdoll, what do we got for you here, buddy? Bunch of arrows and bolts and things like that. Plate armor. Nothing that's really an upgrade. That's not surprising. We're pretty low level. $1,500 gold, though. That's important. And we have a bounty ring. So bounty bandits are put in by Obis, organized bandits in Skyrim. And one of the things they drop, in addition to having better than regular health, better than regular gear, is a ring that essentially you cash in for the bounty on them. So it's usually worth a bunch of money. I don't want to... Skyrim, I don't want to pick up the book. I want to read it. Now I want to pick up the book. We did that already. We're going to take this skooma. No one else can use it. And one of our other characters is definitely not going to sell it for ill-gotten gains. We'll take these coins. We'll read the note. Maybe we'll try one more time to open that chest. It's adept locked. It's got to be good, right? There we go. Money. And ironically, more lockpicks. Hello, new friends. We're just gonna kill all of you. Wow, you're like evil me. You're dead now. Goodbye, everyone. It was good to meet you. Bye forever. Also, let's get that level. So we're gonna go with Magicka. We've got lots of health now. We have three perks. So one of the ones we definitely want to get is Nomad. 50% more horse speed is a big deal. So we can go buy a horse. Is there anything else we want? Our two-handed is almost at 25, which is good. 30 is where it's at because speeding up your attacks is really useful. Alteration, no, we're not there yet. We need to have a magic skill at 25 before we can join the college. So that's one of the reasons why I'm sort of quietly leveling alteration, is so that we can meet that requirement before we have to bring one of our wizards into the rotation. Alright. So, now, soon, we won't be walking anymore. We'll be riding. Which is going to be rad. But for a little while, we're still going to walk. Because we need to turn in that bounty and get another one. We also need to get that quest. Actually, go see the Graybeards, because we don't have it yet. It's a good thing I've played this game for 900 and some odd hours. And I know what I'm doing, apparently. Excuse me, folks. Dragonborn coming through. Dragonborn. Nope. Dragonborn. I have important warning to do. Sorry, something in my throat.
I know your family.
I need to ask you to
Too bad there's more where that came from.
Don't say I've heard of any laws against them. Whatever that is you're doing.
Whatever.
I've got my eye on.
You can't stop me from yelling.
You look tired, Ben.
In fact, I just fortified my shouts. Alright. Boom! I have important yelling to do. Let's wait until we get Janet's armor kitted out. She'll be shouting up a storm. Okay. So, we need to talk to you.
You're fine. I serve Jarl Balder. Excellent.
Turn in that bounty. Get $500.
Here is your reward.
You heard us.
So your visit to Dragon's Reach.
So what happened at the Watchtower?
So now what we're trying to do here.
Was the dragon there?
Turns out I might be something called the Dragonborn. And by might be, I mean definitely 100% am. I absorbed its soul. I drank it like a Slurpee.
It's really worth something.
Masters of the Dragonborn. If you reap,
so they're gonna teach me to be Dragonborn.
Didn't you hear the thundering sound as you returned?
If you played Skyrim before, you know what I just didn't do. But don't worry about it too much. We're gonna go back to it later. We have three companions now. That's enough. Yeah, I'm totally wanting people. The guards, like, considering it, to be fair. So apart from the Graybeards. There's only one other person in Skyrim who can shout. And that's Ulfric, the leader of the Stormcloaks. And a recent current political event was that he challenged the High King of Skyrim, who was a 12-year-old boy, to a duel, and then literally yelled him to death. So the guards, when encountering a person who can yell someone apart, are naturally cautious about such an affair. Mythlon,
take a look.
Let me buy some more spells from you. This guy is definitely not from the regular game. He's part of one of those Cities Reimagined mods. We're going to buy Akato's Recital. Ooh, and we got Conflagrate, which we are not going to be able to cast anytime soon. Frost Armor, Skyfall. Okay. So what Akato's Recital does is it lets us cast a single spell, or up to three spells, actually, whenever we enter a fight. So this is going to make sure that we've always got our buff spells running. And we're going to get that one. And we've also got... What's more Janet? Anti-magic or ice? No, Janet's the Dragonborn. She's super into ice. We can't have both. Otherwise, we'd have both. Okay, so now we've stored two buff spells. Akato's Recital is from Apocalypse Magic.
You there.
And
we're looking for someone in white.
Oh yeah, I saw a bunch of Elikir harassing a woman on the road. It was super great.
A woman, a foreigner.
You're looking. You're just looking for a lady for no reason. Awesome.
We will be in Rorikstead if you learn anything.
Please go away. We'll maybe do this quest later. All right. So we're gonna buy horses. Now we've got our buff spells set up. Like, we're in a good position to basically do the rest of this game. So let's go talk to the stable master. You're going to be my horsey. What's
guy
up?
Like you needs a war horse.
So I would like to buy a of horn course. First. I want the Nordic horn. You always want the Nordic horn because the Imperial horn looks stupid.
Suppose so.
Can I buy a horse? Well, yes.
Got the deal. It's the one with the saddle.
So it's the one with the saddle. Janet's horse. Kate here is my horse's name. It's completely random. As you can see, all my followers get horses. So I have a wonderful, wonderful mod called Convenient Horses. And convenient horses, shockingly, makes horses deeply convenient. We forgot to pick up another bounty, but we're not going to worry about it. So it does a bunch of things. It gives my followers horses. It lets me call my horses in two different ways. So normally you have to... We can name the horse, but the horse actually gets its own name. So its name is Katir, and that will be its name forever. I don't believe there's a way to change it short of me like going in and editing it in the files. I don't want to. I like the random name. Horse picks its own name. I mean, if I let people vote on it, it's just going to be called Horsey McHorseface, and I don't really... not really super down with that. Convenient Horses gives us better horseback combat. By horseback combat, I mean mounted combat, because that's the word for it. And on top of all of that, let's just make sure that we're on the right quest. Yes, speak to the Graybeards. What's up, buddy? What you doing? On top of all of that, how are you doing? Let's chat. Hello.
What
Albus.
Can I do for you?
Hello.
I'm collecting ingredients.
Oh, right, you. Yeah, you're irrelevant. Why are you still here? I thought you were collecting things. No, normally you have to like max out, I think it's either the Dark Brotherhood quests or get most of the way through Dawnguard before you can summon a horse in Skyrim. And while that is a cool perk, it means that for a lot of the game, horses aren't really a thing because you like... leave your horse somewhere and then you can't find them anymore and sad face, etc. But with convenient horses, I can summon them, I can whistle for them, depending on sort of the angle that you're looking for in terms of feelings, is somebody hanging out up here? No. We killed a bunch of people over here last week, and they're still dead. That seems fine. Yeah, we've already come on this road, but now we're going to head up to Iverstead. Because we, if I recall, have never been to Iverstead before. Yeah, Iverstead's down here. And we walk, or now ride, everywhere first. Riding does make that whole, like, walk everywhere promise a lot easier to keep, by the way. We're not calling the horse Horsey McHorse Face. I don't care what you say. All right. The only downside is I don't stop and pick flowers when I'm riding. But I do get a lovely look at the scenery. What's up, goat? Stop and check for directions. I'm pretty sure these signs are from a mod. I think the presence of signs is not, but the fact that they are readable is. And I'm kind of hoping we find something to just, like, hack apart. Oh, no, I thought that was true. That tree stump was a wolf. Because hacking stuff apart while you're on a horse is actually really fun. You just sort of swing around. It's a little tricky, and I don't like engaging in serious melee with it, but if you're just, like, taking a pot shot at something, you can't go wrong. We shouldn't have made that left turn at Albuquerque. But we can get there. What's up, Fox? Yeah, we did kill that fox. Alright. Where the hell are we? Oh my god. We're Darkwater Pass? Do we want to go into Darkwater Pass? Yeah, fuck it. Let's do it. Side trip. It's half the fun of Skyrim, winding up somewhere weird. Being like, yeah, I'll go explore that. We're almost certainly gonna super die in here. Just FYI. Okay. But we're gonna try really hard not to. Sign says, try not to die. Oh, I missed. What is this? Oh, that's what I was worried about. The Charas are a problem. They are terrifying little crawly earwigs. And they're super deeply poisonous. Heal. Check our... we're thirsty, so let's grab another... Just crack a beer in the middle of this dangerous encounter. I spend so much time exploring this game, and that's one of the reasons why I wanted to do the stream, is because I get super unfocused, and I'm like, well, no, I guess I'm...
Are you sure you can find
your way?
Got a
million years. Yeah, it is really easy to get lost in here. Get some Charas eggs. I think I can use these in a blacksmithing recipe. They're definitely useful for making potions, though. Everything you harvest, you can use to make potions with, pretty much. That's disconcerting. Now, if we're super sneaky... Oh, I missed. That was not good. Ha! Take that. The advantages here, we've got some really strong buff spells. We've got three friends with us. And even that is just barely keeping us alive. But there's another companion in here, if we can find him. I don't remember where he is. I don't wanna... Oh, that's him down there. What's up, buddy? If we can free him, he will join our team. He's one of the few archers in the game. So let's see if we can get him out of here. Just gonna pick this lock. Get my lock picking all the way up to 2. We came down this way. Didn't we? There's dead Charas down here. Yeah, this is where we came down, and it was super weird. We could all turn around. Alright. Yeah. So let's see if we can be a pal and liberate him. Do I know how to do that? No. Do I have a torch? Yes. This will make life a little easier. Ooh, a book. Catalog of weapon enchantments. Also, this is some kind of creepy Falmer chest. Cosmic, what's the damage on your steel greatsword? 24. What's the damage on that steel longsword? 21. Damn. Don't worry, dude. We're coming for you. Alright. Now, the Falmer are elves. But they are elves who... have lived underground for centuries upon centuries and have sort of adapted to life underground. So they're blind. They make all their weapons out of, like, Charas, like, body parts and things like that. Their armor's just gruesome. I don't really like the aesthetic at all, but I think that's kind of the point. Well, we found a fine hat and some fine clothes, which means somebody unfortunate died down here. They've also usually... You can find them a lot near and in old dwarven ruins. So, let's pull this lever. I don't know what I was expecting that to do, but it wasn't that. Oh, don't think I don't see you. Sorry about that, buddy. Whoops. You're fine. You're fine. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Everything's fine. I think we're going the wrong way. If we want to free that dude, I think we're going the wrong way. Let's kill these guys and then take a look. Oh, swing and a miss. Oh. Axe is so slow. Oh, there we go. Right in the face. I can just see him flinging firebolts at stuff and I don't even know what it is anymore. Okay. So let's see if we can... Oh, damn! Ooh, that was painful. We're going to want to heal up right away. That was not what I intended in the least. That was unfortunate. Okay. So now we're down here. Where is down here? I don't know. Let's see if any of our buffs have leveled up. Nope. Oh, we went with frost armor, that's right. Yeah, frost armor leveled up. So we can get more frost resistance. More spell damage, more mana. I think we want it to restore. So now when we get hit by spells, there's a chance that it'll restore mana and stamina and make us better fighters. Okay. Is this just where we came in? I think there's dead stuff here. I mean, yeah. We're fine. We got there. Don't even worry. I was all worried because we plummeted off a waterfall, presumably to our deaths. And here we are. We're okay. There's nothing to worry about. Hey, there we go. Head down these steps. Little eggy things, which I find very disconcerting. This is an expert lock. Which means we are almost certainly not going to be able to break it. And yet we do! So I'm a lockpicking god. At least something there are lockpicks in this chest. Dirkethus. What's up, buddy?
Dirkethus from Darkwater Crossing.
Oh.
Should have known better than to swim all the way to the falls. Please, get me out of here.
Yeah, dude, we're totally gonna get you out of here. Don't worry about it. I got your back, man. Now we're gonna free Dirkethus. Oh no, we came up this way. Let's not go backwards again.
Don't go stopping for a nap. If you fall asleep in this place, you'll never wake up.
Thanks, Mercurio. I really appreciate the color commentary. You're right. If I fell asleep here, I would get eaten by terrifying cannibal elves and bug monsters. I really wanted to think about that again. I'm just kidding. I'd kill everyone before I slept here. Don't fuck with Janet. See? Problem solved. Let's not go back down the waterfall, though. Let's instead go through here and take a careful look at this tripwire. There we go. Oh, something's mad. Oh, son, you hit me with that spell. It's just keeping my stamina up. Right. I've only ever been through here like once. Hey, an exit. Oh, and we're hungry. Let's eat something. Cooked beef. Done. Mission accomplished. Darkwater Crossing, if you were here last week, was the town that we stopped in so we didn't freeze to death on the way to Riften.
Thanks. I'm out.
What's up, buddy? Yeah, let's hang out.
We're in this together, yes? Lead on. I'm behind.
We're going to give you some follower commands. Because you're going to be my new best friend. So we're going to make you essential so that we don't accidentally lose you. And we need to give you some stuff. Fandol. We're going to need some gear for Darkeithus. So let's first see what he does. Stats. Alright. So you are good at archery. Light armor. And not much else. Okay. Fandol. Let's find this guy a bow. Imperial bow, sounds good. Let's get him some light armor. Do we have... Oh, yeah, we do. Welcome to the team. Warrior. Here is your uniform. Look at that. Elves, men, lizard men. Rescued from the depths of wherever the hell. Where are we? We are closer to Iverstead than we were. Just need to make sure we wind up on the right side of this road. Excuse me, sir. Sir. There we go. Just make sure we're in a good spot. Yep. So now we can walk. But... What is fighting her? A saber cat! Boom! Eat it, cat! Eat it! Yeah, 4 is about the max for companions for me. I'm actually going to try and maybe drop some of them off. On the break. Because, yeah, 4 is a lot. It starts to get unwieldy. But in the meantime, we were going to Iverstead. So now, we get our horse call. Select our horse call. Blow a horn. What's up, Imperials? Conjure a horse out of literal nothing. Let's ride. On the road, we're closer than we were. We rescued a man from certain death, well, a lizard man. Still a man, still a person. A lizard person, a person of lizard persuasion. An Argonian, technically, to be fair. So we're doing pretty well. Oh, trolls. Trolls suck. We're not going to fight any trolls. If we can possibly avoid it. Spoilers, we can't. We can at least avoid this one, because we are fast, because we have a horse. Iverstead is a stupid town. The reason why I say it is a stupid town is because it is built right next to a terrifying barrow that's probably full of undead monsters. But one of the things that Iverstead has... is the steps. 7,000 steps up to High Hrothgar. Are you serious, game? All right. We may cap the stream off at the break tonight just so I can do some overhaul stuff. Because this is unusually much. Let me close some things here. That should maybe help us out a bit. It's one of those bits where having Skyrim running and streaming and browsers and, you know how it works. My computer is good, but I also demand a lot of it. So we're still on our horse. We're still heading to Iverstead. And we're talking about the 7,000 staffs. So High Hrothgar is the home of the Graybeards, the keepers of the voice. And the voice is what lets you shout people to death. Fine, I'll go fight that troll. Oh, he's coming to fight me. There we are. Oh, there we are. Give me that. Hop back on my horse. Yeah, so the Greybeards can yell people to death. And they're sort of a monastic order that tries to understand dragons. And they're not like me. Not just because they're not Janet, and everyone who's not Janet is slightly, you know, less than Janet. But because for them to use the voice, which is the language of dragons, they have to train for decades and try really hard, and we don't do any of that. We eat the souls of dragons, and as a result, we get to yell things apart. All right, have a good night, TJ. Yeah, it looks like there's a problem with the way that the mountain is loading. Ooh. We might skip this quest for tonight, and I'll come back to it later. I deeply love High Hrothgar, but if it's going to keep messing with me, I'm going to sort out its crap off air. So you don't have to put up with consistent crashes. I think I might be loading something wrong. That's the problem with this many mods, is you can get a bunch of conflicts going. And you can sort out a lot of that, but there's never a guarantee. So let us get off the horse. And let us walk forward a little bit. You really want to walk up the steps anyway. You can ride, but you really want to walk up them. There we go. Because you get to read the little tablets along the way. For the birth of men, the dragons ruled all mundus. Because let's use the Latin word for world. Their word was the voice, and they spoke only for true needs, like blowing shit up. But the voice could blot out the sky and flood the land. I guess. Oh, there's a bear. What's up, bear? Bye forever. Alright. Now we're on a real pilgrimage. Old school pilgrimage. Walking up steps, we got guards. Yeah, there's supposed to be 7,000 steps. I have never counted, nor do I care to. But it's a lot, and with Frostfall, if you're not careful, you can die up here. Oh, we're wet. Correction, we're probably going to die up here. I should turn around. Not going to, I just should. Because High Hrothgar is up here. Oh, I was going to say, the Haunted Room Meadery is on the mountain? No, it's further down. Alright, we got another emblem. Men were born and spread over the face of Mundus, the world. I'm just going to say the world, because Mundus sounds super pretentious. The dragons presided over the crawling masses. Men were weak then and had no voice. If you're a dragon, what can men do for you that you want? Like, apart from, like, sex things. I mean, they make things out of steel and gold and whatnot, and I mean treasure, but really, right? Like, yeah, here's where life starts to get tricky. Now we're getting up into the snow. We're gonna put on our warm armor. Where are our buddies? Okay, yeah, Feindahl, buddy. God, you all look the same. It's awful. I'm gonna need some warmer armor. Words that rhyme, words that rhyme. And do you have a cloak? Get a hooded scarf, that sounds good. Got a bunch of, we got a black wolfskin cloak. Let's go with Timberwolf, let's see what looks nice. Let us take a moment to play dress up on a mountain. So instead of showing off our sick abs, we're gonna put on some relatively sensible fur armor. A hooded scarf. Oh god. There we go. And our Timberwolf skin cloak. What up, wolf? So now we're more protected from the cold. Yes, what you wear actually matters. Thank you, Frostfall and the wear system. I'm just gonna crack apart these wolves. We also have some firewood, so we can make a fire up here if we need to. Was that an emblem? Was that an emblem back there? No, it wasn't. That was a goat. Right. Sorry, goats. They look a lot like emblems. It's hard to tell. Up here is the Moon Forge, which is from a mod that I picked up on the Steam Workshop. And the purpose of it is, and we'll take a brief look at it, because it's rad. The purpose of the Moonforge is that here, and only here, you can forge a bunch of Lord of the Rings blades and other weapons. So you get Sauron's Mace, Sting and Spiderbane, the Witch King's sword, a huge Wraith Greatsword. We are definitely going to mess around with some of this stuff, and it's going to be amazing. And if you're asking the question, am I going to make my blacksmith character walk up here in order to do the thing, the answer is 100% yes. Because we're dorks, and we want to RP it. The struggle, the hardship. Ooh, snowberries. Snowberries are good for you. Oh, Feindahl, I'm with the snowberries. There we go. If anybody sees an emblem, let me know. Alright. Dropping through the snow. Look at this. Look at this world. Look at those stars. The really weird part is, I hate winter in real life. This is the way that I enjoy winter. I'm from Canada. No one likes winter here. That's not true, actually. Lots of people in Canada like winter, and they're all demented. Oh, we got another... We got an pilgrim.
Keep an eye out for wolves. I was just outside Iverstead when it happened. It's an exciting moment. Walking the steps.
Meditating
on the emblems. Just a pilgrim. I'd prefer to leave it at that, if you don't mind.
Emblem 4, because we missed one. Kine called on Parthenax, who pitied man. Together they taught men to use the voice. Then the dragon war raged. Dragon against tongue. So basically, yes. Sex things. Alright, let's... try and speed up a little bit. Partly because walking meditative steps is deeply not action-packed. But also just because... freeze to death. To death! Alright, hardest thing here. Basically the mini-boss of the mountain. Well, the boss, I guess. Is this troll. There's a frost troll, which is stronger than a regular troll. Cool. We're gonna take it apart. That was the big thing I was worried about. That and the cold. Emblem 5. Man prevailed, shouting Alduin out of the world, proving for all that their voice was too strong, or their voice too was strong, although their sacrifices were manyfold. Alduin, being the dragon that we saw at the beginning in Helgen, he is back. And with him comes all the other dragons. It's super not great. Oh yeah, if you have to fight a dragon on the top of this mountain, which you can with the mods that I have, which I hadn't thought about, it's awful. It's just dead awful. So let's hope that doesn't happen. It's not even, like, hard fun, it's just hard. Because you've got limited ranged attacks. I have limited ranged attacks because RP restrictions, etc., etc. But also, yeah, it's just, yeah. We are now freezing. Okay. Let's check out this emblem. Tongues at Red Mountain went away humbled. Jürgen Windcaller began his 7-year meditation to understand how strong voices could fail. Now, Red Mountain is the volcano in the middle of Morrowind. So that's intriguing. And that was like the big deal final boss place in Elder Scrolls 3, which was Morrowind. You fought a man or a god who is making a bigger god, or a powerful being who... Morrowind's full of really powerful beings who claim to be gods, but they don't exhibit what you would think of as the voice. Oh, which is apparently yelling for my horse because I didn't put my shout back on. What's up, everybody? Dirkethus, get on your horse. Yeah. That's apparently the power. Racking up those light armor skills. So my armor skills level with the kind of armor that I'm wearing as I walk. So the longer I walk, the more levels it gives me just from moving around in it and getting better at moving around. And here we are. High Hrothgar. Freezing. If that bar maxes out, we pass out and either die or wake up in the nearest town. So let's find ourselves a brazier and get warm. That one's not even lit. Oh no. What's up, monks? Let's give us like 20 minutes. Alright, we're just gonna wait here for an hour.
So, Dragonborn appeared.
I'm answering your summons.
Show us, Dragonborn.
There we go, now we're warm again.
Let us taste of your voice.
Let us taste of your voice. What's up, buddy?
Dragonborn, it is you. Welcome to High Hrothgar.
I am Master Bomb-ass robes.
I speak for the grave. Now, tell me, Dragonborn.
Why am I here? I'm Janet. I want to find out what it means to be Dragonborn. I want to understand this newfound power that I have and how it's going to make me an incredible warrior that's completely unstoppable.
You are not the first. Whether you are the only
Dragonborn. I am the chosen of Akatosh. We established that in the first episode.
Thus far. That is all I can say.
Alright, let's learn this stuff.
But, without training, you have already taken the first steps towards...
Oh my god. Skyrim loves apostrophes. So much, so deeply.
When you shout, you speak in the language,
speak the
of,
language
dragons.
Of dragons. Thus, the language of dragons is get out of my way.
Inborn ability to learn words of power. All shouts are made.
Why do I have dragon blood? Sex things.
As you master each word, your shout will
God, you guys look so handsome. Strong.
Master Einarth will now teach you Roll, a second word in unrelenting force.
Right.
Roll means balance in the dragon tongue.
If you just go like project it on the floor.
Force to focus your thumb or shot.
And then I am going to absorb it into my brain. When I am standing at the right angle. There we go. Oh! I just ate the words right off of that pavement. Dude, it's just moonwalking around the room. Can you teach me that skill? Can I just like... Right, like this, right? Like this? Oh, it's all gone wrong.
As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding.
Weird. Double weird. You guys might want to get out of the way for this next bit.
Use your unrelenting force shout.
Because, well, okay. Sorry, buddy, I told you to move. Just gonna wait out that cooldown.
Well done. Again.
Do the thing. There we go. What is the purpose of being able to yell into existence a hologram Graybeard? I mean, presumably, I guess you can make a hologram of whatever. But.
Impressive. Your film.
Yep. Pretty cool. Now, how is this going to make me even more badass than I am? By the way, I can take off my cold weather gear now. So, let's do that.
Follow Master Boy.
There. We're all going over the courtyard now. Translation. I should put my hood back on and my cloak so I don't freeze to death. Fine. There we go. Oh god, bald! Yeah, if I don't have my helmet turned on, that, it's not so good. Okay. You gonna do the thing? You're just gonna download more stuff into my brain. These guys are actually pretty cool. I like the idea of a monastic order that's sort of semi-completely pointless. Like, they learn awesome magical powers that are chiefly just for blowing shit up. And, then they just sit up here. And I don't use them for anything. Master Bori will give you his knowledge of this thing you need to progress in the main quest. And also, it's kind of cool. Please let me do this the whole time, on the first try, because if I crash into that game, it's going to be really embarrassing. Oh, he's going to show me how to do it first. You needed a yell to open the gate.
Stand next to me. Master Bori will open the gate.
You couldn't just open it.
Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes.
You're right there. You could just open it. There we go.
Your quick mastery of a new form.
Yeah, I'm Dragonborn. What are you gonna do?
Astonishing. I'd heard the stories of the ability.
Life taker, heartbreaker, etc., etc. Yeah, I thought it was this easy for everybody. But no, it turns out I'm special.
Beware that your skill does not.
And by me, I of course mean Janet.
You are now ready for your last trial.
My last. Oh, yeah, it's been like 5 minutes. Okay, sure.
Our founder from his tomb in the ancient.
Ah, the tomb of Ustagrav.
Remain true to the way of the voice. You will return.
Okay.
I am up.
So now we're at the Horn of Jürgen Windcaller. And we're going to take a break for about 10 minutes or so. So. Yeah, I'm going to grab a drink and fiddle with some things, and we'll be back in about 10 minutes. All right? Cool.